Miroslav Petkov has just started his fifth season as solo trumpet, but during that time, he has made a very big impression. Charming and good looking, and this amazing ability to not take himself too seriously. It's a delight to have him in the orchestra, and he's done pretty well considering he didn't pick up any instrument until he was 11 years old. 11 years old.
Yes, 11 years old. I was.
That's
a long time ago.
That's quite late for a musician. I mean, a lot of them start early.
Yeah, but it's, with the trumpet is, or brass instruments, it's a bit different.
Yeah, that's true.
Because we are not really considered musicians.
So, I mean, your parents musical?
No, my dad actually, he was a truck driver for many, many years.
A truck driver?
Truck driver.
How does that even work? If you're just in a normal family, you find a trumpet, how does that work?
I wanted to play a trumpet because I was watching cartoons and stuff, and I for some reason, for odd reason, I somehow saw the trumpet and I kind of liked it. And then we went to this school in Bulgaria, in Varna, my city, and it's like a school of arts. And then I said, I want to play trumpet. And then I actually saw how the trumpet looks. And then I was so disappointed because the trumpet in the cartoons looks completely different. You know, it looks like a pipe, like meep, meep.
Yeah.
And yeah, but then I had to do it anyway because my parents paid for the lesson, so.
Is it just music?
It's a national school of arts where you can study classical music, you can study folklore music.
And is this where the interest in folk music came from? Is, I guess, you grew up with this, all these different sounds?
Yeah, in Bulgaria, the folklore music is very strong. It's just all around you always, even if you don't like it. I started with a classical education, though. I was not allowed to play anything else than classical music. And then, but I was working in kind of a restaurant with live music. And I remember this restaurant was close to the music school, which is near the beach. And sometimes I would see my trumpet teacher going for a walk with his wife and I would just disappear.
So he didn't approve?
He didn't approve, no, no. It was probably the right thing to always kind of kick my butt. With some people you can be free, with some people you really have to kick their butt, and I was one of these.
But what's fascinating about that and your life now, you're also bringing in Bulgarian folk music, trying to show your influences to an audience that has no idea what region you're playing from, and frankly, we'll never know.
Yeah. I'm interested in certain things, like folklore. I'm interested in jazz, so I put some work and interest into it too. Classical music, obviously.
Well, I think it's fair to say that most classical musicians have only studied classical music. I mean, do you find playing in the orchestra restricting?
Yes. Yes, of course it is. That's why also you are doing, apart from playing the orchestra, something else that you love.
Yeah.
So that's how I feel about it. I mean, in the end, I'm so lucky that we play in this amazing ensemble with great people. But the more you can make it not a job, the better it is.
Yeah. So it's a delight. As always, Miro, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.